What's worse than knowing? Knowing you're not alone. Hearing about you. 1 a.m. on my phone.
I think we're all actually pretty ill right now, which is fun. But I'm on the end of it. I think the boys are still struggling as well. So we're fine. We're getting by. We're happy. We just did a tour and we haven't toured for, 2 years. So it could be worse. Yeah.
Oh my God. It was so good. That first show was, we obviously haven't played a show in so long. So it was so fun to be back out and actually see people singing songs back to you. That song, we wanted a song that kind of like followed on, like after, because our album had come out, in the February time. And I think Worst came out in like April time. So it was kind of like a nice way, like, pardon me, like straight after the album to just have like another song out that kind of like follows on, that can, we can take our music in a different kind of direction sort of vibe. But then obviously the pandemic hit, and then everything stopped. So it gave us a lot of time to really figure out where we wanted to properly take our music. So Worst was a cool like little stepping stone, like post album. So yeah, it's given us a lot of time, to kind of figure out the next steps of where the New Hope Club sound and the New Hope Club new music will go. I know that in the music video, we all had to wear wigs. I had a lot of people say that I looked like Taylor Swift with the long blonde hair. So that was quite a weird comparison, I guess.
Thought it was Taylor Swift in our music video. That's news to me.
Oh yeah.
It was you, George.
Sorry, mate. Sorry to disappoint. I know.
I was telling everyone that Taylor Swift was in our music video. I mean, we'd love to do something with BTS at the moment. With them being fans of the band as well, we thought, it's something we should probably do. So I think once we're able to be, back over in Korea, we'll, try and, do something like that. But there's loads of people that we'd love to work with, obviously, we're huge fans of the Beatles, so like work with Paul would be very, very cool, just for that experience. And then, even like, people like Ed Sheeran and, they're amazing writers, just to like learn from them, would just be incredible.
When we were on tour, we actually played two brand new songs that no one had ever heard before on the tour. So, we'd written those over the lockdown. So I think it's just been good for us to figure out where we're going to go, and also to work on the project of the second album, and write as many songs as we can for that. I think the songs that we've played already I'm sure someone's probably recorded and put online somewhere. That's probably illegal. No, I'm joking. They're probably online somewhere. So I think from those, you can kind of get the sort of gist and the vibe of the road that we're going to kind of go down for that album number two. Legally.
I don't know about... Worst, I'd probably say it won't be on the next album, personally. Just because we released that, pretty soon after the second album, straight after the first album, as sort of something to, for the fans to have. But then since that point of that release, that's when we started writing everything for the next project. So that probably doesn't fit exactly with the sound of the new project. But legally, I can tell you that Trouble in Paradise and Broke is Broke are two songs. I think what was really, really amazing was the fact that, well, for two things really, is that we were, you know, we never really get the time to like actually sit down and write and, you know, create a piece of work instead of it just being like, let's just write a song. And it's like usually dead really, really fast. But we actually had a lot of time to really focus and, you know, relook at everything and, you know, think about where we wanted to go and everything. So that was like, I'm really grateful that we had that, you know, that time, because I think that's set us up for, you know, this second album and also for the rest of our career. I think it's like really, really exciting. And then the second thing is that we've worked a lot with a specific writer, which I'm probably not allowed to say who. I don't know if I am. I'm not going to, just in case. He taught us, you know, so, so much. And he was somebody that, you know, really saw what we wanted to do and the, you know, the passion that we have for music. Like, we're not just an artist that like wants to just, you know, do songs and not really, and just tour it. We want to like make music that we love and that we're really proud of. And he saw that, and he's, you know, he's really helped, you know, allow us to achieve that. So I think that's been really, really just, it's been awesome, yeah.
You don't, or
keep playing.
Oh, keep playing. Okay.
Sounds like the Rolling Stones to me.
It is the Rolling Stones, yeah. Want to guess the title?
Is it, it's not like a... No, I don't know.
She's a Rainbow, though. Rolling Stones. I'll give you half a point.
She's a Rainbow.
Yeah, I'll give you half a point. You
beat us, though.
Something I think you'll understand when I say that something I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand.
I'm sorry, I wanna go and trust me. We can
we
have
could have got that. We could, you could have stopped that in the first second and we would have got it. It was
we used
it
to play
was
that on
Journey
tour.
With Don't Stop Believing.
I want to hold your hand.
Want to hold your hand, the Beatles.
Yeah, good job. I'll give you both a point each because I heard it from both of you. Okay.
No, George, trust me, George knows that as well.
Yeah, obviously.
You know, we all get a point.
All get a point.
I was going, no, I don't know.
We played that live. There's no way.
I saw Blake.
September, Earth, Wind & Fire.
Good job. I guess their scores are Blake 0.5, George 1, Reese 1. So obviously, Blake, you won. The challenge. Good
Wait,
job.
Wait, didn't I get Rolling Stones as well, though?
You did, but you didn't get the title.
So sure, that's half point, no?
Yeah, that's half a point. I counted 0.5.
Oh, sorry. Just a bit competitive.
Just thank you very much for all of your amazing support. We love you very, very much. And yeah, keep been amazing online. All of the online support is great. We see it all the time. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts, and enjoy the new music when it comes out, and we'll see you very, very soon.
Blake, Reese, anything else to add to that one?
Just, we love you.